Global Steel Services is a state-of-the-art metal fabrication plant. They manufacture precision-made metal parts for construction, cladding, sheet metal, sign supplies, and many other uses. They make purlins and metal decking of any size. They specialize in customizing any structure to suit your unique needs. Visit them at 42.5 miles on the George Price Highway or give them a call at 671-4118. Global Steel Services, leading the way in steel structures in Belize.
Coming soon to San Ignacio, Reimer's Feed Mill Pet Care offering quality services to your pets that include bathing, clipping, dental care, grooming, deworming, and vaccination. Treat your pet to the best experience and the expertise care. Make the bond stronger and lasting. Call us to book your appointment at 824-0105. Reimer's Feed Mill, we're growing Belize.
Some moments are worth the journey. We'll help get the most out of every mile. Chase down your passion. Never halfway. Hankook Tire.
Did you know?
Did you know when you retire, the Sagicor plan pays? When your child needs a college fund, the Sagicor plan pays. When you pass away, the Sagicor plan pays. If you become critically ill or disabled, the Sagicor plan pays. The Sagicor plan always pays.
I had a really good time tonight.
So did I.
Life moves fast. Be prepared with Sagicor. Learn more at sagicorlife.com.
Good morning and welcome to Morning Matters. Our guest this morning is Mrs. Earlette Shepherd. Mrs. Shepherd is going to be sharing her life's journey with us today. This is something that you definitely want to sit by and stay tuned to or stay in tune with, simply because it is a journey that I would imagine that a lot of us can relate to, not only as human, but as wanting the best for our bodies and how our bodies to look and function. Earlette, good morning and welcome.
Good morning. Thank you.
Thank you for coming. First, let me say you look good.
I'm going to start
from that position. Not that you never looked good before, but now you look a lot more healthy. But before we get to that, I want to talk a little bit about how you got here, because I can't imagine that it was an overnight journey. I want to talk a little bit about your early childhood. Where did you grow up? How did you grow up? So let's start with where did you grow up?
Okay, I was actually born in Dangriga because my mom is from Dangriga, and we came to Belize when I was a baby. And so I grew up in Belize City on, now we live in Faber's Road. So I've been here for a couple of years, and I had a, with friends and kids around us, it was a fun childhood, you know, so,
for most of my years.
Yes, I do. I have three sisters and one brother.
Where do you fall in? Where do you fall in the lineup?
I'm the third. Yes, and we still communicate together. We still communicate, and we have my siblings and I had, you know, we have a very good relationship. So I'm very happy for that.
What was it like in your home? You know, you have three. You said three girls. So it's what, four girls and one boy.
Mm-hmm.
Four girls and one boy. Did you have both parents present? And what was the chore situation like? Because I would imagine that everybody feel that the boy probably get the best out of the whole situation. So kind of explain that to us.
Well, I grew up with both parents until my dad went to the States when I was like in second form. And it was always, my brother was the baby. And so it was always one baba for the king, one baba for the king. And the chores, you know, I remember my dad would put a crate, it's time for you to wash up. And we would have our chores. And when we come home, we knew exactly what we needed to do and stuff like that. And people have always told my mom that we were very mannerly. So they probably did a good job.
Which high school did you go?
I went to St. Vernon High School, and I completed my 4 years, and I entered into UB nursing, and I never completed, but I'm here today.
Excellent. What did you have dreams of becoming?
Well, I've always liked to cook, you know. My mom, she has her own little business too that she does bread and buns. So I've always loved the kitchen. And when I think about food, my mind would just go wild. So I want to become a very professional chef one day.
You know, Earlette, you definitely have a lot of time on your hands and you are definitely moving in the right direction. I want to talk a little bit about your food choices when you were growing up, because when I first saw your pictures, and I'm going to show the pictures in a little while, you were not as skinny, if you will, as you are now. So I want to talk about your time as a young teenager. Were you always a heavy teenager? Were you always more on the plus side when you were growing up, or that happened later in your life?
No, I've always been a chunky girl. I can remember I've always been, you know, big, and with kids, I gain more weight. And I whenever I eat, I used to always eat this way. I used to always have like a chips, a biscuit along with my food, like always. And so I never looked at it like, I never had any side effect or any sickness. So I never paid my weight any mind.
When you were growing up, did your weight affect the way you function with your peers?
No, I've never, I guess that's why I never looked at it like, it's a bad thing to be fat, because I've never had an effect from my friends, or, you know, nobody wanted to hang with me. So it never, you know, I never had any problem with that. I was actually working at Youth Enhancement Services for, I think it was like 5 years, I think, or a little more than that. And then I had my first son. And I had my first son while, before I start working there. So as he grew up, I was working there. And then I met my husband, my now husband. Mm-hmm. Well, I have one husband.
I like it.
When I met my husband in 2009, I think, and then we got married in 2010, and then after I stopped working at YES, I never had another job like YES. It was basically just stay-at-home mom, and then I got pregnant with my other son, and so my husband was he is a very good husband that takes care of me. I didn't have to work. I just had to stay home and take care of the kids and stuff like that.
You went from working outside to working inside. A lot of people don't recognize that you went from freedom to a more strenuous job. I want you to discuss a little bit of that, because I would switch out with you and I would not switch out with you at all. I would always take the outside job as opposed to the inside job. And a lot of people don't get recognition for the stay at home and the homemaker, but that job don't have no hours. At least your job on the road have hours. What was that transition like for you when you realized that, you know what, now I'm going to be a homemaker?
Up to now, it is very difficult. I told my husband this morning that I am tired. My shoulder is hurting me because it's like around the clock. Because now I have 3 kids. I have my daughter who's 1. And then this homeschooling. So it is very difficult. And some days, yes, I would want to leave the kids and go. I told my husband, I said, one of these days you're going to come home and not find me here. Because it's very hard. It's very hard. I told my son yesterday, I said, I think I sweep like a 1,000 times for the day. Like, I keep sweeping the carpet because the kids keep coming in, going out, coming in, going out. So it's very difficult. And And I also have to make sure that when my husband comes home, I have his food ready. You know, he have to come home at least to a clean house because he's out there working. So it's very difficult.
How do you manage your time? I would imagine as a homemaker, time management is imperative, or else the husband will come home to no food, one dirty house and screaming children. How do you, and you still have to be teacher in this day and age. So how do you manage your time?
Okay, so when I get up early in the morning, my husband usually leaves early. And so when he leaves, I would start by getting my standard one son work prepared. And then about 7:40, I would wake my older son that is in first form for him to start logging on to his classes. And if I have any keto stuff to make, I would start making those things. If I have any others or anything, I would start before my daughter gets up. And so I try my best to schedule my time. And even though some days it's not as I would want it to be, I still try my best to make sure that I have everything completed for that day. So I don't really have a time schedule like after my son gets up. It's just if I need to do anything, that's how I do it.
But, you know, I think you need to recognize that you have a good start. You have a way that you start your day. And because you have a way that you start your day, it normally filters in just the right way. If you didn't have a rhythm in which you start, you'd have more difficulty. And we're going to go to break. But when we come back, I want to talk a little bit about your decision to have started to eat differently. So we're going to go take a break and be back.
Some moments are worth the journey. We'll help get the most out of every mile. Chase down your passion. Never halfway. Hankook Tire.
There are several benefits to eating rice regularly. Whether you're looking for a protein-rich food for your vegan or vegetarian diet, or looking for an awesome pre-workout meal, Country Foods Rice is an ideal candidate. Country Foods Rice works in many ways to improve your body's overall health. It also is a great source of energy, improves nervous system health, gluten-free, and is a natural anti-inflammatory. Country Foods Rice. Look for our products in a store near you. When you're having a good time with family and friends, it has to be followed up by a great meal. And great meals begin at Country Meats. When it comes to high-quality steaks at everyday low prices, Country Meats cannot be beaten. So, whether you're cooking for one or cooking for 20, barbecuing a favorite or grilling a classic, it has to be from Country Meats. Country Meats, where high quality, excellent prices, and outstanding service meet. Check us out at your nearest supermarket or inside any quality poultry products outlet. Country Meats, providing the highest quality and variety when it comes to steaks and other meats in Belize.
I chose Galen because of its strong reputation.
Great scholarships.
I came because I can take all my classes online.
Because Galen University opens doors to the outside world.
Their course offering in tourism.
It gives me more opportunity to become who I want to be.
If you want to connect with your inner champion to make the world a better place, then Galen is right for you.
I choose Happy Cow Cheese because of its perfect portion sizes and I can travel with it.
Because it's nice and soft and creamy and it goes smooth on your bread.
I choose Happy Cow Cheese because I eat it with my beans. I eat it with my fried jack. And you know why? Because it's nice.
Most of all, when you're on a plane, you know they only give you some crackers and you could just take one out and enjoy it with Happy Cow Cheese.
I'm Miss Baker, and I choose Happy Cow Cheese because it goes well with all the stuff I bake.
Happy Cow Cheese. Look for it in a store near you. Distributed in Belize exclusively by Emilio Ahmad & Sons Limited.
Here at Cope Sheet Metal, we believe our job is very essential in serving our customers. And that is just one reason why visiting us is an experience to be remembered.
Here at Cope Sheet Metal, we have a reliable fleet of trucks. We specialize in countrywide delivery of all our material.
Cope Sheet Metal is a family business that was started by my grandfather, who even had many of his machines hand-built decades ago to make our products the most reliable in Belize. Come, visit us at our new facility on Iguana Creek Road, just past the Belize River, leading to Spanish Lookout.
New Buildings Limited is the company of choice when it comes to design, fabricating, and erection of wide-span metal buildings in Belize. At New Buildings, we have a team of well-trained professionals that can produce the most innovative and durable metal structures. Be it domestic or industrial buildings, we can get it done for you. We have put together some of the most outstanding metal structures in the country. We also do estimates and consulting. Visit New Buildings in Spanish Lookout or give them a call at 631-8723 or 610-5185. New Buildings Limited, the experts when it comes to metal structures in Belize.
P-TECH has been in Belize now for more than 6 years. We specialize in residential and industrial high-quality glass windows and doors.
I chose P-TECH windows because they're the highest quality I can get.
I chose P-TECH windows because I'm quite impressed about the way they're manufactured. These are double pane glasses. They're called low E. That keeps out a lot of the heat.
Check us out at p-tech.com or give us a call at 671-3842.
Welcome back to Morning Matters. Mrs. Shepherd in with us this morning. Arlette, welcome back.
Thank you.
Arlette, now I want to talk a little bit about your weight. Why? Because it's something I want to talk about for even, not only for you, but for a lot of people. Because you don't have to weigh 200 pounds or 150 pounds to feel sometimes that you are not at the weight you want to be. So tell me first, how much did you weigh and when? Your highest weight.
Okay, my highest weight was 247.
And what is your height?
5'5".
So you were extremely overweight. What made you, what was the factor that caused you to say, I'm going to do something about this?
Okay, so I realized that I had 3 C-sections and I wasn't going to have any more kids. And so that was one of the factors for me. Another one, with the pandemic and the lockdown, my sister and I start working out. And I just felt like, all right, well, we're not doing anything, so let's start working out. But then I realized, like, hey, I'm doing this and I'm not seeing anything. Like, and that really discouraged me. You know, like every day I would go out there for an hour, kill up myself, and I'm not seeing anything. And so I went on Facebook and I saw a pastor from Jamaica, Pastor Renee Brackett. And I saw she lost a lot of weight. And so I messaged, first I posted my food and I thought I was doing good. And she messaged me and she said, too much carb in the plate. I was like, what? And so I messaged her and I asked her, you know, I said, I saw you lose a lot of weight. I said, how did you do it? And that was when she introduced me to the ketogenic diet.
That is a word that a lot of people are using. And I don't know how it fully works and what the results are. When I spoke to Tessa a few days ago, yes, I'm going to say her name. I saw Tessa and I said, like, what have you been doing? She says, well, if you think I look good, look at this. And then she showed me you. And I am marginally overweight, if you were to go by the scale. But I am not at my ideal weight. I'm heavier than I have ever been. And I'm just trying to lose 15 pounds. Because I can feel it in my body. I don't think that I'm a person that is vain, per se. But I want to feel good. I want to be able to jump up on a step. I want to be able to run 3 miles. I get tired I am not the same energy level as I was before. And I thought, you know, maybe if I lose a little bit of weight and I get in shape, I can live longer and I can see my child and my grandchildren if there is any in the future. So I said, how did you do it? She says, then she starts to tell me about the diet. But it is not the diet that convinced me to ask you to come here. It is the results that you have gotten and both of you that I have seen. I mean, I know her in real life. You understand? So I said that this conversation could be good for everybody that gets the opportunity to look at it. I think that a lot of times we feel that it's that is for the birds. It is for the other people and it in our work for me. But you are proof that it has worked and it is working and it will continue to work. What is one of the first things that you did when you started this journey?
Okay. So when I started the journey, I honestly, that was the first time I heard about ketogenic diet. And I was like, okay, cutting a little carb, no sugar. I got this. I could do it. And the first 2 days, it was hard. I started researching, can I really not put a little bread in there? Can I really not put a little tortilla in there? And there was no way around cutting the carb. And I think it was like a week, I had took a picture with my back. So before I started, I took a picture with my back. And I think into a week of it, I took another picture and I saw a little result. And I was like, you know what? I need to continue this. And with me not knowing about the diet, not knowing about other stuff that I need to incorporate, like I said, it was difficult at first. And I just kept going because I start seeing a little result. And
okay, so tell me, me about the diet. Tell me how the diet works. So let's start from there. And then afterwards, we're going to see how we can incorporate it in our lives. Because it seems so doable until I say, so Earlis, where am I eat this morning? Understand, like that now it becomes, I need to find a way to be able to eat, still feel satisfied, still nourish my body, and then get the end result. So I need to figure out how to do that. So first, tell me how the diet works and how you start it.
Okay, so ketogenic diet is a high fat, healthy high fat diet. When people hear about the high fat, they kind of squinch like fat. You're trying to lose fat and I'm going to put fat in. But your body, whenever you start lessen the carb, your body actually start burning the fat. So putting in healthy fat will allow your body to start burning those fat. So your carb intake for the day is under 50 grams. And there's a lot of things that for me that I had to actually learn on my own. So I created a menu and I created a grocery list. So, and there's drink in Belize that you could actually drink because people think it's only water. So to my time, I know that Coke isn't good, but I would, you know, have some Coke and I would buy sparkling water. Those are things that helped me through the diet. So in the morning, I would have omelette and my waffle from almond flour.
Okay, slow down because, you know, this is a high fat, no or low carb diet or no carb diet.
Low carb.
Okay, so some high fats would be like, I could pigtail, I have to ask, as I think about fat, I think about pigtail.
Yes, I eat pigtail. So the high healthy fat are like coconut oil, olive oil. They have
I could eat bacon.
Yes,
that's the acid things that were like I could eat pigtail, bacon.
Yes.
I could eat a nice beef patty.
Say it again.
I could eat like a nice beef patty.
Yes.
Like meat, like the meat.
Yes.
So I could eat any meat and the fattier the better. The natural fat that it has, the better.
Yes. Yes.
Starting to sound good so far. So We're going to get into the meal plans in the next segment. But for this segment, I want to talk a little bit about what are some of the things that I can drink? Because now that you say that, I can't eat any sugar. I can't consume any sugar. Can I have honey?
No.
Why can't I have honey when honey is a natural substance?
Because
that to me, because I've been cutting out sugar and drinking honey like there's no tomorrow, Earlet. You will not believe it. I have two honey bottles open because whenever I pour something, I pour honey on it because that's my savior. Am I killing myself?
Because honey is actually, you know, it turns into actual sugar. So what I would do, what I used to do, I used to cut up the cucumber and put it in a freezer. So if I want a little cucumber juice, I would take out a few and I would blend it and I would put, you have Splendor sugar. I would put like 2 Splendor in there, or you have monk fruit sugar. Those sugar are what people with diabetes would use. So when I say no sugar, you actually have sugar replacement that you could use that's actually going to do the same, you know, give you a nice taste, and that just blending the cucumber without putting any sugar in there. And like I said, water is to the top of the list. Water is to the top of the list. And some people, like my sister, when she drinks water, she gets cold. She has cold feet. She doesn't like water. So you have sparkling water that you could drink. It's really nice. And you have to keep you could do juice that's actually keto-friendly fruits, because you would be amazed to find out the amount of sugar and the amount of carb food have. I was amazed to see.
So you're saying that some of these natural juices are not recommended for the diet?
Yes. Like watermelon.
You are killing me here, Earlet, because I have been thinking that I have been on a roll, not with the keto diet, but with staying off sugar. So I say, I want watermelon juice. Give it to me with no sugar. I feel like I'd help this body. Give me some orange juice, no sugar. I feel like I'd help this body. You're killing me here. I eat banana all the time. Papaya.
Those things are sugar. If you're on the diet, you can't have those things.
What?
But after the diet, you could have a little, but it's a lifetime change. So now, when you get to your goal weight, it's for you to maintain it. So during the diet, you could have strawberry. Those things that, you know, you have strawberry, you have, I think it's kiwi.
Uh-huh. Can I have pineapple?
No.
I can't have custard apple. A custard apple season earlier, it'll kill me. Yeah.
You could have star apple. Is that the star apple you eat?
I don't want no star apple. What custard apple?
But you have to look at it this way. Do I want to get healthy and do I want to lose weight, or do I just want to enjoy those fruits?
A little bit a little bit of both.
But another
another question that I have for you is, how long before your body gets into ketosis? And what is ketosis for the people that don't understand that term?
Okay, it takes like a week. It depends on your body too. So I would give it a week into 2 weeks for your body to get into ketosis. Now there's some little strips that you would use to pee on, and it's going to tell you if your body's in ketosis. And I always tell people that I talk to, once your body gets into ketosis, your body's going to start burning the fat. If you're on the diet and you're doing it the right way, I promise you, in a week to 2 weeks, you're going to see some results. But you've got to be very disciplined and very strict.
Two things that I have difficulty with.
I'm just joking.
Really just joking. This lifestyle change, it cannot be temporary. It has to be something that is going to be long lasting, or else you're going to fall back into your old ways and your old weight. How long have you been on this path?
Okay, I started the diet June 1st and I came off it November 30th. And during that time, it was Christmas. And I did enjoy my Christmas meal. And actually, I'm in a group from Jamaica, Renee's Wellness. And that's an accountability for me to remember I need to eat healthy, I need to exercise. My husband and I, we're actually going to start back the diet next month. So that's what, because I need to come up with a plan now. I lost the weight, but I need to come up with a plan in order to maintain the weight. So that's what I'm actually going to work on now. When can I enjoy a little fun meal, I would call it, so that I'm going to come up with a plan how I could help people after they lose the weight, how they could actually maintain the weight. Because yes, it's a lifetime change, but sometimes, you know, we get invited to different stuff or somebody wants to take us out. What? Can I not have a piece of cake? So it's just for you to maintain it after you lost the weight. So I'm on the path right now to maintain the weight that I've lost.
Yeah, because it's one big thing to go and lose the weight, but to maintain the weight is definitely the biggest challenge. What has been your biggest challenge during this time?
Okay, my biggest challenge during this time is because I haven't been eating those things like from June to November. I tend to, whenever I, like I'm eating cake, like I have a slice of cake, I feel like I want to go back. And there's a reality check in my head. I said the Holy Spirit, he convicts me. Like, all right, that's enough. And I appreciate it, like seriously. All right, Earl, that's enough. You know, so you have to let yourself speak to yourself. All right, that's enough.
Well, Earlette, I will probably need for you to speak to me and tell me, all right? That's enough. Does it help? I would imagine that when you are on this diet, everybody in your home is on this diet. So it's one cooking all the time. For me.
Yes. First, it was difficult for me because my husband wasn't on it. And one day I told him, I said, you know, do you want to go on a ketogenic diet with me? And one thing about my husband, once it's something good, he's on board. And so my kids weren't fully on it, but my older son, he could cook. So I would tell him, I say, you know, can you prepare breakfast or can you prepare dinner for your little brother? You know, and he would do it. So that part, I would just have to prepare for my husband and I, and then my older son would prepare for my little son. So
that worked out. So I would imagine that if you are living in a home with children and husband or wife, depending on who it is, it works easier when everybody is on the same path, because that way it's one meal, it's one system, there's no pressure. You look in the fridge, there's no brownies waiting to be eaten inside the fridge. There's just one shopping list. We're going to take a break. When we come back, we'll talk a little bit about examples of what you can have in the morning for lunch and in the evening and treats. Some practical examples on how to get you started on this diet and how to get you to your ideal weight or to your goal weight. We'll take a break and be back.
Some moments are worth the journey. We'll help get the most out of every mile. Chase down your passion. Never halfway. Hankook Tire.
There are several benefits to eating rice regularly. Whether you're looking for a protein-rich food for your vegan or vegetarian diet, or looking for an awesome pre-workout meal, Contrafoods rice is an ideal candidate. Contrafoods rice works in many ways to improve your body's overall health. It also is a great source of energy, improves nervous system health, gluten-free, and is a natural anti-inflammatory. Contrafoods rice. Look for our products in a store near you. When you're having a good time with family and friends, it has to be followed up by a great meal. And great meals begin at Country Meats. When it comes to high quality steaks at everyday low prices, Country Meats cannot be beaten. So, whether you're cooking for one or cooking for 20, barbecuing a favorite or grilling a classic, it has to be from Country Meats. Country Meats, where high quality, excellent prices, and outstanding service meet. Check us out at your nearest supermarket or inside any quality poultry products outlet. Country Meats, providing the highest quality and variety when it comes to steaks and other meats in Belize.
I chose Galen because of its strong reputation.
Great scholarships.
I came because I can take all my classes online.
Because Galen University opens doors to the outside world.
Their course offering in tourism.
It gives me more opportunity to become who I want to be.
If you want to connect with your inner champion to make the world a better place, then Galen is right for you.
I choose Happy Cow Cheese because of its perfect portion sizes, and I can travel with it.
Because it's nice and soft and creamy, and it goes smooth on your bread.
I choose Happy Cow Cheese because I eat it with my beans. I eat it with my fried jerk. And you know why? Because it's nice.
Most of all, when you're on a plane, you know they only give you some crackers, and you could just take one out and enjoy it with Happy Cow Cheese.
I'm Miss Baker, and I choose Happy Cow Cheese because it goes well with all the stuff I bake.
Happy Cow Cheese. Look for it in a store near you. Distributed in Belize exclusively by Emilio Ahmad and Sons Limited.
Here at Coop Sheet Metal, we believe our job is very essential in serving our customers. And that is just one reason why visiting us is an experience to be remembered.
Here at Coop Sheet Metal, we have a reliable fleet of trucks. We specialize in countrywide delivery of all our material.
Coop Sheet Metal is a family business that was started by my grandfather, who even had many of his machines hand-built decades ago to make our products the most reliable in Belize. Come, visit us at our new facility on Iguana Creek Road, just past the Belize River, leading to Spanish Lookout.
New Buildings Limited is the company of choice when it comes to design, fabricating, and erection of wide-span metal buildings in Belize. At New Buildings, we have a team of well-trained professionals that can produce the most innovative and durable metal structures. Be it domestic or industrial buildings, we can get it done for you. We have put together some of the most outstanding metal structures in the country. We also do estimates and consulting. Visit New Buildings in Spanish Lookout or give them a call at 631-8723 or 610-5185. New Buildings Limited, the experts when it comes to metal structures in Belize.
P-TECH has been in Belize now for more than 6 years. We specialize in residential and industrial high-quality glass windows and doors.
I chose P-TECH windows because they're the highest quality I can get.
I chose P-TECH windows because I'm quite impressed about the way they're manufactured. These are double-pane glasses. They're called low-E. That keeps out a lot of the heat.
Check us out at p-tech.com or give us a call at 671-3842.
Welcome back to the third and final segment of Morning Matters. Earlette having a chat in with us this morning on her life's journey, how she's managed to lose how much pounds, Earlette?
About 55 pounds.
You lost about 55 pounds in what space of time?
About 6 months, June to November.
Hurricane season.
Oh, yes.
You lost 55 pounds in... from June to November. How have you been able to hold it off? We are now in March.
Yes, I still do eat my healthy meal. And I noticed that I don't eat as much as I used to eat. I get full quicker. And I drink a lot of water I don't snack. I don't do the snacking in between because that actually helps for you to put on some more pounds, doing those snacking in between. So I would just do a lot of water during the day.
Lots of water, no snacks. This is a diet that some people say is very, very difficult to maintain both financially and physically. You know, the commitment is huge. Let's talk a little bit about the physical commitment that you have to live up to, the discipline that you have to have within yourself. How are you able to live up to that discipline?
Okay. My husband actually bought me a station bike, and so it's right in the comfort of my home. But before that, I would do my squats in the morning, and I would just do some workout at home just to make sure that I'm actually getting at least 30 minutes 3 days out of the week.
Okay.
And so that's how, because, you know, life becomes rushy at a certain hour. And so I make sure I either before I go to sleep or early in the morning, I get in something at least three times for the week.
So you get 30 minutes of exercise at least three times for the week. How do you stay committed to the meal plan? I mean, life gets crazy. A lot of the things that you eat or want to eat are not readily available. So how do you stay committed to that?
Okay, so when I actually first started, I actually was preparing meal for people. And so that helped me too, to eat what I'm cooking. But now what I do, I would just, I still have to prepare meal for my husband in the night. And so during the day, I don't have breakfast most of the time. So for lunch, I would just do veg or meat along with something out of my box. And in the night, some nights we would just have like a wrap or something like that. No, because I could eat those little low carb turkey. I think Publix sell it. I call it low carb because it's not high in carbs.
Yes. So you say you eat turkey in the night, but when you were on the diet, when you were fully invested in the diet, what was your meals like?
My meals, sometimes I would just eat a chia pudding, and it's chia seed along with almond milk and a few splendid sugar in there, along with two waffles or one waffle.
When you say waffle, but waffle is made out of flour.
All right, these waffles are made out of almond flour. So the almond flour contents, I would do either waffle, pancake, or almond flour bread. So my stuff that I eat are almond flour stuff. I'm not talking about the white flour, it's almond flour. So throughout the time, I would have or muffin.
All from almond flour?
Yes, out of almond flour.
Okay, so let's say I say, you know what, Earlette, I want to start this diet Monday morning. What would be the first thing that you would recommend that I do?
Okay, the first thing I would recommend is for you to take a look in your house and try and get all of the unhealthy stuff out of your house, simply because it might tempt you. And if you live with a household with kids and husband that will not be on a diet, then it's just for you to make your mind up. It's a mind thing, right? So for you to make your mind up and to say, you know what, I want to lose 10 to 15 pounds in the month of March. So you have to discipline yourself.
You say that like it's so easy. I wake up this morning, I say, you know, generally in the morning, I eat two boiled eggs and I drink a hot cup of tea. That's generally when I'm by myself, that's just how I live. That's naturally how I live. Maybe once in a while, I'll put some crackers with it. But generally, that's what I eat. But then there are days when I want, but then I put honey, a lot of honey in my tea. Right? So you're saying that's okay, but lose the honey.
Yes.
For lunch, I eat anything. I eat absolutely anything because I like, not only that, I'm on the road a lot. So when I'm on the road, my meal is not, I can't determine where I will stop or what I will eat. So for somebody like myself that is always moving, like I don't sit in my house or I don't have an office that I go to my office, to my house. So I don't have a routine like that. Sometimes I'm in all over the place. How can somebody like me manage to achieve this goal with the lifestyle that I live?
Okay, if you're on the road and you have to eat out, you could get a salad, a grilled chicken, and if, because I mean, actually, there's nothing out there that you could actually get. Like, if you can't get rice, so it would either be meal prep, or if you know you're going out, you have to make your mind up, okay, I'm going to do a salad and I'm going to do grilled chicken, or I'm going to do fried fish and salad, and take along something from out of the keto box with you. A muffin.
Can we talk a little bit about the keto box? Yes, because the keto box sounds like the savior. And in the evenings, because again, I'm on the road a lot in the evenings. And even when I'm here, I come home, I'm tired, I don't want to cook. I eat, I stop by Cheers, I buy a loaf of bread, I make a sandwich, and I call it a day. You know, what are some ideas for the evenings?
Okay, for the evening, you could have a big omelet along with a waffle, or a pancake, or a muffin, or just a muffin and a shake, a keto diet shake. So in my shake, I would use a spoon of peanut butter, I would use almond milk, I would use Splendor, ice, cinnamon, and I would just blend it together. And you're good to go.
All right, so people can find you if they are interested in getting meal plan ideas. But you also spoke of a keto box. There is something that I saw in your box that I want. I want it because I want the waffles, I want the bread, and these are not things that you can go and get in the store. You have to order them from persons like yourself. So if you tell me a little bit about your keto box and how it works.
Okay, so my keto box comes with a loaf of bread, 14 slice. It comes with 3 muffin. It comes with 2 pancake, 4 piece of waffle. And it comes with 2 donuts.
Okay, let me stop you for a minute. You say come with all of these things that is made from almond flour. So how do I preserve my waffle? Because I don't want to eat it today. I want to eat it Friday. How do I keep it fresh and fabulous that I can eat it Friday and I don't feel like I have this piece of... Yeah, how do I do that?
You could put it in Ziploc. You could wrap it up in the plastic wrap, and you could put it in Ziploc bag in the freezer. And whenever you're ready, like you said, you want to eat waffle on Friday. So now you're going to get up. You're going to take out your waffle, leave it out there for a little while, you know, do what you got to do until you're ready to eat. Or you could warm it in the microwave for just a few seconds. And you're going to be good to go.
Or I can pop it in my toaster.
Oh, yeah, you could do that.
So I will freeze this food and I will eat it when I feel like. Mm-hmm. And I ask also because the bread and these things are not cheap and I don't want them to spoil if in the event I'm away for a few days. They're just sitting around in my fridge. So when I get this keto box, depending on what it is that I get in this box, I can freeze the content. And when I'm ready to utilize it, I can just put it in my microwave or my toaster or wherever it is that I want so that I can defrost it and warm it up, if you will. What is in this box? How much is this box? And where can people find you to get this box?
Okay. The things that are in the box, like I said, it's the loaf of bread, the waffle, the pancake, the donuts, and the muffin. And it's $60 for those stuff. And you guys, I have a Facebook page, Keto Snack Box, and I have an Instagram page too under the name Keto Snack Box. Or they could call me or message me on WhatsApp at 614-3074.
I eat with 2 things, my eyes and my taste buds. So it needs to look pretty and taste good. Is there any deviation in the taste? Like, will I lose the nice taste of a waffle because I am using this flour?
No, you won't, because I try to make my stuff. The only difference with this is the flour and the sugar replacement. I stick with, if I use almond milk or stuff like that, because my stuff are all keto friendly. So I always make sure I spice my stuff up with the right spice. Love and it. So if you want to purchase the box and you say, you know what, I prefer the waffle more, then you could go ahead and purchase the amount of waffles you want.
And people can find you on Facebook under what name?
Keto Snack Box.
Keto Snack Box. And you can ship these boxes all over the country?
Yes.
And these snack boxes are primarily for maybe breakfast or dinner, but yes, not for lunch so much. Or if you want to make a sandwich, I guess there's things in it. And the boxes start at $60?
Yes.
Excellent. I am super excited. And now I have to place my order. When we're finished with this, I'm going to place my order for a box. I want to be specific. Can I customize my box? Because maybe I'm not a person that wants muffins or that kind of stuff. Maybe I'm just interested in waffles and bread. Can I make a box to suit my needs?
Yes, you can. Because I actually have a price list with this stuff, with the different prices. So now that's in the box. But beside the box, I do pizza. I do bun. I do vanilla cupcake. I do a different amount of stuff.
So you can have a keto snack, is what you're saying?
Yes.
Excellent. Earlette, I have to say, you definitely have been an inspiration to me. Is the reason I have you on here today, because I saw how much weight you lost, and I am hoping that you can help not only me, but other people, to motivate us to do the right thing, to eat the right thing, to provide the right options for us. It's good that you have a box that we can purchase, and that will help us through the day. I am going to commit myself to this with you. So if anybody sees me on the road, not offer me nothing when I come in at the box, or that is not keto friendly, at least
until you reach your goal weight.
Until I reach my ideal weight, the weight that I am looking for. And then we can go from there, but I'm not going to start it this weekend. So if you see me this weekend, we can still eat cake, you know, have a good time. But I'm going to start it bright and early Monday morning. And
That's
what I'm going to do. And I'm going to, I say it publicly because I want to be held accountable. I don't want nobody to say, I never say. So I'm going to say it. I'm going to do my best to see how, this is an experiment. If it works for me, it can work for you. And because my life is a little bit active in terms of, I'm not home all the time and that kind of stuff. So if it really can work for me, it can work for you, because a lot of people are more stationary and stable than I am. So Earlette, let's do this. Let's see how it works. And next conversation we have will be hopefully me 15 pounds lighter.
And one more thing I just want to say, when you purchase the box or anything from me, I give you a week meal plan along with a grocery list.
That is what I will need. That right there. Earlette, again, I say thank you. Have a lovely day. Bye.
Okay, you too. Bye-bye.
When you're having a good time with family and friends, it has to be followed up by a great meal. And great meals begin at Country Meats. When it comes to high-quality steaks at everyday low prices, Country Meats cannot be beaten. So, whether you're cooking for one or cooking for 20, barbecuing a favorite or grilling a classic, it has to be from Country Meats. Country Meats, where high quality, excellent prices, and outstanding service meet. Check us out at your nearest supermarket or inside any quality poultry products outlet. Country Meats, providing the highest quality and variety when it comes to steaks and other meats in Belize. There are several benefits to eating rice regularly. Whether you're looking for a protein-rich food for your vegan or vegetarian diet, or looking for an awesome pre-workout meal, Country Foods Rice is an ideal candidate. Country Foods Rice works in many ways to improve your body's overall health. It also is a great source of energy, improves nervous system health, gluten-free, and is a natural anti-inflammatory. Country Foods Rice, Look for our products in a store near you.
Coming soon to San Ignacio, Reimer's Feed Mill Pet Care offering quality services to your pets that include bathing, clipping, dental care, grooming, deworming, and vaccination. Treat your pet to the best experience and the expertise care. Make the bond stronger and lasting. Call us to book your appointment at 824-0105. Reimer's Feed Mill, we're growing Belize.
P-TECH has been in Belize now for more than 6 years. We specialize in residential and industrial high-quality glass windows and doors.
I chose P-TECH windows because they're the highest quality I can get.
I chose P-TECH windows because I'm quite impressed about the way they're manufactured. These are double-pane glasses. They're called low-E. That keeps out a lot of the heat.
Check us out at p-tech.com or give us a call at 671-3842. Global Steel Services is a state-of-the-art metal fabrication plant. They manufacture precision-made metal parts for construction, cladding, sheet metal, sign supplies, and many other uses. They make purlins and metal decking of any size. They specialize in customizing any structure to suit your unique needs. Visit them at 42.5 miles on the George Price Highway or give them a call at 671-4118. Global Steel Services, leading the way in steel structures in Belize.
I choose Happy Cow Cheese because of its perfect portion sizes, and I can travel with it.
Because it's nice and soft and creamy, and it goes smooth on your bread.
I choose Happy Cow Cheese because I eat it with my beans. I eat it with my fried jerk. And you know why? Because it's nice.
Most of all, when you're on a plane, you know they only give you some crackers, and you could just take one out and enjoy it with Happy Cow Cheese.
I'm Miss Baker, and I choose Happy Cow Cheese because it goes well with all the stuff I bake.
Happy Cow Cheese. Look for it in a store near you. Distributed in Belize exclusively by Emilio Ahmad and Sons Limited.
Did you know?
Did you know when you retire, the Sagicor plan pays? When your child needs a college fund, the Sagicor plan pays. When you pass away, the Sagicor plan pays. If you become critically ill or disabled, the Sagicor plan pays. The Sagicor plan always pays.